I have taken permission of the speaker to remove the. அனைவருக்கும் மாலை வணக்கம். திரு ராம்நாத் ஜி கோவிந்த், ஆனரபிள் பிரசிடென்ட் ஆஃப் இந்தியா, திரு எம் கே ஸ்டாலின், சீஃப் மினிஸ்டர் ஆஃப் தமிழ்நாடு, திரு எம் அப்பாவு, ஸ்பீக்கர் ஆஃப் தி தமிழ்நாடு லெஜிஸ்லேட்டிவ் அசெம்பிளி, திரு கே பிச்சாண்டி, டிப்டி ஸ்பீக்கர் ஆஃப் த தமிழ்நாடு லெஜிஸ்லேட்டிவ் அசெம்பிளி, திரு சஞ்சீவ் பனர்ஜி, சீஃப் ஜஸ்டிஸ் ஆஃப் மத்ராஸ் ஹைகோர்ட், மினிஸ்டர்ஸ், மெம்பர்ஸ் ஆஃப் பார்லியமெண்ட், மெம்பர்ஸ் ஆஃப் த லெஜிஸ்லேட்டிவ் அசெம்பிளி, டிஸ்டிங்விஷ் இன்வைட்டீஸ், லேடிஸ் அண்ட் ஜென்டில்மேன், இட்ஸ் எ கிரேட் ஓனர் and privilege to participate in the centenary celebration of the Tamil Nadu legislature and also witness the unveiling of the portrait of the former Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Thiru M. Karunanidhi. We are all honored by the presence of the Honorable President of India, who is here today to grace the commemoration of 100th year of Madras Legislative Council and also unveiling the portrait of the illustrious son of the Tamil Nadu, Thiru M. Karunanidhi. I convey my appreciation to the Speaker of the Assembly, the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, and all other members of this august house who are associated with the centenary celebration. On this historic occasion, I pay my sincere tribute to all those stalwarts and veterans who have left their indelible impression on this house. Their visionary zeal and foresight were instrumental in the enactment of important and historic legislation in the Tamil Nadu legislature. These legislations paved the way for the creation of a progressive state. India is the largest democracy with the finest written constitution in the world. The evolution of the legislature was a slow and steady process, ground and refined through various acts. It has to be noted that the first elected legislature in the state, originally called the Madras Legislative Council, was established in 1921. Thus, this year, 2021, is the centenary year. I must add that the first legislative council stood out for its commitment to the upliftment of the disadvantaged section and women in Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu legislature has been many legends like Thiru Pangal Raja, Thiru C. Raj Gopalachari, Thiru T. Prakasam, Thiru K. Kamraj, Thiru M. Bhaktavatsalam, Dr. C. Dr. M. Karunanidhi, Dr. M. G. Ramchandran, Selvi Dr. J. Jayalalitha, and many more. I would like to remember the first woman legislature of modern India, Dr. Muthu Lakshmi Reddy, who joined the Madras Legislative Council in 1927. This was made possible because the first Legislative Council, whose 100th year of formation we commemorate today, voted in favor of the women's suffrage resolution in 1921. Dr. C. N. Annadurai, who was popularly known as Aringar Anna, was an inspiring and path-breaking leader whose oratorical skill and his respect for the three cardinal principles of duty, decorum, and restraint won wide acclaim. Aringar Annadurai was instrumental in getting the name of our state changed from Madras to Tamil Nadu, fulfilling the long-cherished aspirations of the people of Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu can be truly proud of this galaxy of leaders and legislators who have contributed to the establishment of a strong parliamentary tradition. and democratic culture in India through their work in this assembly. The Tamil Nadu Legislative Assembly has a great history, being one of the oldest and early legislative houses in the country. Several landmark legislation have been introduced here. They include pioneering schemes in the area of social justice, eradication of untouchability, women and child welfare, education, eradication of poverty, the welfare of the marginalized, including the transgenders, etc. Many of these have been the bedrock of policies and programs in the entire country. I would like to briefly to touch upon the greatness of Thiru M. Karunanidhi, also called as Karagnar, and Muthumir Aragnar, was a versatile leader who held the masses mesmerized by his oratory. For a person to be a chief minister of Tamil Nadu for 5 times and to win every election that he fought in his political career is indeed a remarkable achievement. He entered politics at the tender age of 14 years and was elected as a member of the Legislative Assembly 13 times. He remained undefeated in all the elections he contested from 1957 to 2016. He was respected for his political acumen and ability to strategize by political leaders from all parts of India. He was a member of this house till his demise. John Stuart Mill, a great parliamentarian, said that in a representative democracy, the legislature acted as the eyes, ears, and voice of the people. The legislature represents the public will. The legislature operates under a system of collective decision-making. In addition to official law-making capacity, most legislatures perform an educational right by simplifying complicated issues and defining policy choices. It is in this context that we have to appreciate services rendered by Dr. M. Karunanidhi, who was held in high esteem for his vast knowledge in a variety of fields. The dynamism he exhibited in administrative matters and his brilliant debates are etched in the annals of this august house. The foundation of the fame of Dr. Karunanidhi and the fulcrum of his greatness was in his extraordinary command over Tamil language. This mesmerized even his political adversaries. I am reminded of this couple at Thiruvalluvar. Mighty in word of unforgetful mind, of fearless speech, it is hard for a hostile power to overreach such a man. The political decency of Karunanidhi could very well be shown by an incident. That is, during the year 1972, several freedom fighters, including Thiru Rajaji, were chosen for award in appreciation for their services and their participation in the freedom struggle. Thiru Rajaji could not attend the function and requested Thiru Karunanidhi, the then chief minister, to receive the award on his behalf from the then governor and send it across to him. On 2nd October 1972, Thiru Karunanidhi received the award on behalf of Thiru Rajaji, and on 3rd October 1972, he went to Thiru Rajaji's home, garlanded him, and handed over the award. This was greatly appreciated by Thiru Rajaji, and the gesture of a chief minister going in person and handing over the award. Thiru Karunanidhi won the hearts of lakhs of people of Tamil Nadu, especially the poor and the downtrodden. He was rightly called people's chief minister. His novel schemes, like the scheme for correction of vision, beggars rehabilitation program, introduction of cycle rickshaw instead of hand-pulled rickshaw, creation of slum clearance board, law for equal property right for women, marriage assistance scheme, distribution of wasteland to the landless farmers, free electricity to farmers, the formation of many labor welfare boards, free color television, Samatun, Samatun Puramas, to eradicate caste discrimination and gas connection to the poor. This was a wonderful scheme. All other states, they should eliminate it. Connection to the poor, rice at subsidized price, speak volumes of his dedicated services for the upliftment of the poor. With a political span covering nearly 7 decades, Karunanidhi was familiar with all the Honorable President of India, all the Honorable Prime Minister of India, and the Chief Minister of various states and heads of various political parties. He stands as a role model for the members of the legislature at all times. I like to remember fondly the meeting between two tall leaders, Honorable Prime Minister of India through Narendra Modi ji and through Karunanidhi ji on 6th November 2017. I accompanied Honorable Prime Minister and met through Karunanidhi ji. It was a wonderful meeting. We also met through Stalin, who received Honorable Prime Minister and was present during the meeting. I think you were in the foreign, no? You came that day. Wonderful. Being a legislator has at once a privilege and an honor, which also bring with it clean rights as well as responsibilities. It is through the elected representatives that the sovereign will of the people finds expression in our legislative bodies. The trust and faith which the people have reposed in you need to be justified with sincerity and commitment. As people's representative, you all are entrusted with the challenging task of keeping the flame of democracy burning bright. The members of the newly constituted 16th Assembly may have come from different parts of the state and may belong to different political parties with varying political ideologies on this occasion of the centenary celebration. I appeal to you to work together with a common goal of serving the people and for the progress of the state. I congratulate through M. Appavu, Speaker of the Tamil Nadu Legislative Assembly, through M. K. Stalin, the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, all ministers, all members of this house and all others who have worked hard to make this centenary celebration a grand success. It is my fervent hope that all of you will strive relentlessly to enrich this august house like your forebears did. With a strong commitment to social and economic justice, let this assembly be the leading light to whole nation in the future also. Nandari Vanakkam. Jai Hind, Jai Tamil Nadu.
Thank you, sir, for your enlightening speech that outlined the various historic movements of this Tamil Nadu Legislative Assembly. The chief guest of the centenary celebrations, the Honorable President of India, Sri Ramnath Kovind, will now address the gathering. Sir, may we now invite you to address the gathering.